Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy. Brett Somers. Nipsey Russell. Marianne Mobley. Richard Dawson. And Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. Thank you, Johnny Olson. I think you're ready. I think you're ready to participate in whatever you're going to participate in here. Are you ready?
Yes, it's on the outside.
You look just dandy. You're not ready?
No, I said we can't wait.
Oh, good. All right. Well, let's begin by saying hello to our two players here, Robert Spencer Jr. and Kathy Stone. All right, Kathy. Good. Kathy is our current champ. She's won one game as a total of $350 to her credit. And she is being challenged now by Robert Spencer Jr. I think you ought to repeat this little story you told us yesterday about yourself, because some people, or whenever it was we were together last time, might not have heard it. So.
Oh, I just said that I have just graduated from a television and radio school here in Hollywood, and I hope to eventually become a host of a game show, and I hope I be as well and do as good a job as you do of the Match Game 73.
Right. Thank you very much, Robert. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
We'll start this game right after we finish this. We are ready to start a brand new game. Robert Spencer Jr., the challenger makes a selection, so would you do that, please?
I'll select A.
He selects A. It is. Everyone plays. The president said...
Ha-ha! Prove it.
We don't know what he said.
What he said.
We don't know what the president said. Let me tell you what... Oh, you don't have to know. No. Listen to the president said...
He won't say.
Let me make one thing perfectly clear.
Yeah?
At this year's White House masquerade party, I don't want anybody dressed up as... blank.
Wait a minute.
This year's...
Could you hear all of that?
No, I didn't.
You didn't. Shall I repeat it for your benefit?
Please do.
The president said, let me make one thing perfectly clear. At this year's White House masquerade party, I don't want anybody dressed up as blank.
I can't seem to get it.
It's only three letters.
No, it isn't. It's four.
No, it's eight.
Are you thinking about this, Robert Spencer? Okay, he's thinking about it. He's got his answer probably already. I don't know what you're holding you up over there. All right, we're all set now. Robert, give us your response to this. At this year's White House masquerade party, I don't want anybody dressed up as...
jackasses.
For the Democratic Party, yeah.
Or donkeys.
Oh, donkeys. Oh,
or
yeah, I see. Okay, all right. We'll accept donkey, Robert. It's all right with you. Okay, he says donkey.
Donkeys
is a symbol of the Democratic Party.
It's a very good answer. However, I said he didn't want anybody dressed up as a bug.
As a bug. No bug. Okay, there's one answer and no match. Brett, what do you say?
Well, we all know what a politician is, but he didn't want anyone dressed as a statesman.
As a statesman. President
don't
said,
you
let me
get
make
it?
One thing perfectly clear. Yeah, I get it. I don't want it.
We got it. We got it, Brett. Thank you.
This year's White House masquerade party, I don't want anybody dressed up as...
Well, during the Watergate proceedings, I learned that SOB meant Senate Office Building, so I put a senator.
A senator. All right. Robert's looking for the answer, donkey. What do you say, Marianne?
Well, I muddied the water a little further, and I said Sam Irvin.
Sam Irvin. Okay. Now, Mr. Dawson, what do you think about this whole proceeding?
Well, darling, where I come from, the twilight bird has lights in front and a bug near his...
I see. Okay, so he's a bug. Donkey is Robert's answer, and Ann.
In hindsight and in point of time, I said Senator Irvin.
Senator Irvin. Okay, so there's no match there. Let us move to Kathy Stone's assignment, and this is it, Kathy. Everyone participates once again. Sarah said, just because Marvin is blank, it doesn't mean he's not a nice person.
Just because Sarah Marvin said. Is what?
Sarah said, Just because Marvin is blank, it doesn't mean he's not a nice person.
Oh, okay.
Got the idea.
I've got a lot of ideas.
Well,
I don't know what to do with them.
Choose one. Kathy will think of an answer now that will attempt to match all six celebrities.
Oh, dear.
Sarah said that. Just because Marvin is blank, it doesn't mean he's not a nice person.
Well,
I don't understand what's so mystifying about that, do you? Nipsey's ready. The bottom tier is ready. Upper tier.
Oh, it's the first time they beat us this week, the little devils. Come along.
Well, I'm trying.
Now he's ready. So we'll come over here to Kathy Stone and see how she responds. Sarah said just because Marvin is blank, it doesn't mean he's not a nice person.
Just because Marvin is ugly.
Ugly.
Yeah.
Oh. Doesn't mean he's not a nice person. He's beautiful
That's
inside.
That's a beautiful thought.
It is a lovely thought. Let's see if
I take
scores
offense to that. I'm married
true,
to Jack Klugman.
He's a nice person.
And the middle syllable
now,
of that name
we'll
is...
get up to Bert Convy here.
Yes, well, ugly is a very lovely thought. That's true. I said just because he's a pervert, he's a nice person. I don't know. I couldn't think of any villains, you know.
Okay.
You Brett, did all right.
I never met a pervert I didn't like. I don't know.
What? What does that mean?
I don't. Will Rogers said that.
Shall we move on over here?
Well, I just saw the nicest person I ever knew was my daddy, and he was a drunk.
He was a drunk.
Nothing wrong with that.
Because he's a drunk. That's pretty good.
All right, Nipsey.
Well, I know Sarah, and I know Marvin, and Marvin is stupid.
He is stupid. Okay, just because he's stupid is not nice, doesn't mean he's not a nice person. What did you say, Marianne?
Listen, Brett's right. He was drunk.
Drunk. Okay, that seems to be the answer here.
I happened to know that Marvin and Sarah had been necking, and then...
Then he got drunk?
She sort of straightened herself up, came in and said to her mom, just because Marvin's aroused, it doesn't mean...
person. He goes off.
Okay, Anne.
Will Rogers like to, also said
yeah, would you like to carry on, Anne?
I would love to carry on. With whom?
Well, or Marvin. Marvin. Marvin's ready.
I know that Marvin. Unfortunately, the Marvin I know was a sissy.
Okay. So there was no match there. We'll go to round two and ask Robert to make a selection.
Yes, I'll stick with A.
He wants A once again. You didn't match anyone in the first time. That means everyone plays now.
So far, we've been brilliant.
Yes. Frank said, I've really got my wife trained. I ring a bell and she blanks.
I don't think that's...
Frank said, I've really got my wife trained. I ring a bell and she blanks. Richard had a thought immediately.
I'm the best.
You're the best, Richard.
Oh, I can't say that. Thank you. I've been first.
Yes.
All right, just put it right in the slot there. As long as you're finished with it, do not tarry.
Third card is going to be in his mouth.
Third card.
He has a little trouble.
Okay. Now, Robert, what do you say? Frank said, I've really got my wife trained. I ring a bell and she blanks.
Jumps.
She jumps. He says, I ring a bell and she jumps. What do you say, Bert?
I said, he rings a bell and she jumps out of her clothes. I said, disrobes.
Disrobes. Okay. Brett.
Well, you've seen Jack and me together on this show.
Yes, we have.
Jumps.
Jumps.
Why did I say what I said?
All right. There's
I
one match.
I was thinking about Pavlova's dog. She eats the Avon lady.
Ring a bell and she eats the Avon lady.
Oh, that's terrible.
Well, so let's come down here. Pull yourself together. Up you go here. Well, you pick this card up and you hold it up and you say the answer at the same time. I'll say it for you.
Stop giggling.
She says, brings my slippers. Okay, I'll put the thing in the slot part.
Let's put her in the slot.
Put your head back down again. All right, sir, would you give us your answer? Just keep it down there.
Does he blow a whistle or ring a bell?
He rings a bell.
And she comes to it.
She comes to it.
All right. Okay.
And after that, she attacks me.
She rings a bell. What'd you say? Well, You scored once with that. The folks just here in the nick of time. We have a commercial message for you. All right. In the first half of round two, our final round here, Robert Spencer scored once. We are now going to the second half. Kathy, you need one match to tie. Two will win the game. And everyone plays.
Everyone plays.
Listen to this, folks.
We're going to do that.
All of Sally's muscles are in her blank. All of Sally's muscles are in her blank.
All of Sally's
I can hardly wait for this one.
I know what I'm thinking.
Don't say it yet. Until they've finished writing. Rhett and Nipsey are not finished. And you can't think, right? Okay. Everybody ready over there. Now, Kathy, think carefully before you give your answer. Remember, one to tie, two to win. All of Sally's muscles are in her blank.
Sally does a lot of horseback riding and other events, too. And all of Sally's muscles are in her legs.
All of Sally's muscles are in her legs. She said legs.
We heard
what
her
do you
say.
Say? Bert.
I said all her muscles are in her head.
Her head?
Yes.
That's a good answer. What do you think of that? Okay, Brett, what do you say?
I don't want to hear any cheap talk about this not matching. Calves, which is
calves.
In your legs.
Well, I don't know. I've got to make an appeal from the judge.
Yes,
that is a match?
I knew it.
Okay. All right, the score is now tied. If you match Nipsey, you'll win another game. Go, Nipsey. She's looking.
I match Bert.
You match Bert.
And I win the game, right?
No, you don't win anything.
Oh, I don't win anything.
You guys can go out together later if you'd like to. What do I care? Mary Ann.
And I match Nipsey and Bert.
We'll all go together.
Right.
We're split all
right.
Anyway.
This little place.
Let's see now. If you match Richard Dawson, you could win the game.
Sally had to be an English girl.
Really?
And they were in her London derriere.
In her derriere.
You had to be there, I guess.
Yes, I suppose so. All right, Ann, last chance. Here we go.
How about fourth for bridge with the other members?
Oh, hey. All right. Head it is. We've got a tie here. We've got to go to a tiebreaker. To do that, we'll wipe the board clean and push the button, and the tiebreaker will appear. One question. The one who scored the most matches will be the winner. Challenger always goes and make a selection.
I'll stay with A.
You got to stay with A. Right. Okay, Robert, here it is. This is his tiebreaker. Everyone plays.
Does Robert still want to be a host of a game show?
Not anymore.
Henry the traveling salesman said, "Hello, room service? Send up a blank, quick." Henry the traveling salesman said, "Hello, room service? Send up a blank, quick."
I love the way you do it. I mean, say the line, of course.
See you later.
That's what he told me.
Everyone plays on this. Already down here? Marianne, are you still thinking? What are you doing?
Oh, she was blowing in my ear. It's my
oh,
ear.
Oh, all right.
She's blown in everybody's ear today here. Or okay. Here today.
All right, they're all finished.
That's
all right, Robert Spencer Jr., give us your answer. Henry, the traveling salesman, said, "Hello, room service, send up a blank, quick."
Well, if I was Henry, I would want a woman.
A woman?
Yeah.
Okay, he says...
Very understandable.
He says, "I want a woman." Bert, what do you say?
I said, "Send up a broad."
Bert. Oh, okay. Light lights up, so there's a match. Brett?
I said, "Chick."
A chick.
M. I put the EN underneath there in case you didn't. So does that count?
Well, now, I don't know. She's got chicken here.
Chick.
Chick in big, bold letters and EN in fine print.
Because I'm a girl, and I thought, well, they'll only get hateful.
Oh, I see. So chick is your answer.
Yes.
All right. Well, that's a match. All right. Nipsey, what do you say?
Well, Henry was a young traveling salesman. I said, send up a girl.
Send up a girl. Okay. All right, Marianne.
My mother is going to be thrilled with my terminology, but I said abroad.
Abroad. Mom, your little girl said that. Marianne, former Miss America, said that abroad.
Henry right, actually picked up the telephone, said, "Room service? Send me a room." Well, it's cleaner than broad, isn't it?
That's not a male chauvinist pig answer.
I wouldn't give one.
All right.
Exit is over
Let's
there.
Let's find out what Ann Elder says.
You and I went to the same comedy school, right, didn't we? Send up our room, please.
Send up a room.
We have two rooms.
Okay, so you scored four times with
Both
that.
Of you, the exit
now you must match there. Four celebrities, Kathy. Five, however, could win the game for you. All right, everyone ready?
We're ready.
Here we go. Everyone plays.
Sure.
This is her half of it.
Where did I get my leg up here?
She's got her leg in his pocket.
Can we have a little dignity?
Yes, I'm terribly sorry, Doc.
It's a serious show.
So far, yes.
Well, we didn't intend it. It just turned it out.
You can always tell a Texan by the way he blinks. You can always tell a Texan by the way he blinks.
You can always tell a Texan, but you can't tell him much.
We just lost Dallas.
If there'd been a back door to the Alamo, San Antonio would be in Mexico.
And Mexico.
All right, now they're all finished, Kathy. You think carefully before you give an answer. What answer you think will match the celebrities on this? You can always tell a Texan by the way he blanks.
By the way he walks?
By the way he walks. All right. Let's find out what answers we get.
No, dear, we said Texan.
Here. Got a
Texan. The strange Texan.
Sissy was
Listen.
Silly Texan?
Bert, he's silly. You can always tell a Texan by the way he...
Mine rhymes. I can't read it. Oh, yes. By the way, he talks.
He talks.
Yes,
sir. Here's his walks. All right, Brett.
Well, my dearest friend is, her name is Angelique, and she comes from Texas, and she talks real funny.
That's it. All right, talk. Now, you got to match the remaining celebrities to stay in the game. Nipsey.
Well, I like them barbecues. It's the way we talk now.
Oh, we've got a new winner, Robert Spencer. Congratulations to you. Come on, Bob. Here we go. Stand right there, everyone, please. We got the $100. We congratulate you. And we're going to say goodbye to Kathy Stone. She's going to leave with $350. Together with our thanks for being on Match Game 73, Kathy Stone. All right. We'll get back to this fellow here right after we pass along these messages. This fellow's won his first game, and I guess he's excited about that, aren't you?
Yes, I am. My anti-pressure just stopped working.
All right, stand over there, and we'll come back. No, I'm only kidding. You've got $100. You're going to go with the big money now here in the Super Match, Robert. And we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank chips. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you can match it. The second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Okay, you're allowed a little help from three celebrities to suggest answers, one at a time, if you would, please.
Marianne.
There are a couple good ones, but potato chips.
She says potato chips. All right, there's one answer for you.
Nipsey.
Nipsey.
Well, this isn't actually our national game, but I said poker chips.
Poker chips. All right, there's two for you.
Richard Dawson.
My national game, fish and chips.
Yeah. Yes.
Fish and chips. All right.
And no salt or vinegar, please.
There. Poker chips, potato chips, and fish and chips are the three you have been given. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I'll go with the potato chips.
You'll go with the potato chips. Okay, he says potato chips. That's the answer he's looking for. Let's all together take a look at that $100 response. Mr. Chips.
Goodbye, Mr. Chips.
So long, loser. So long, Mr. Chips. All right, that's not it. We're still looking for potato chips. We are now going to show you the $250 response.
Damn,
poker chips.
Right there.
Attaboy, Nipsey, that was your answer, but it's a loser. Here we go. Third and last chance for potato chips. Here is the $500 response.
Yes,
potato chips. So, Robert, you win the $500. That means you're up to $600 altogether now. And that means also you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to collect that, you got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. and your answers must be exact. So turn around and choose a celebrity.
I'll go with Marianne again.
Okay, Marianne, you get ready to write. Robert, you face me. Here is the $5,000 question.
Listen, opposites attract.
Lucky blank. Marianne will write her answer to that. Lucky blank. Can't take too much time, Marianne.
Oh, wait just a minute.
Lucky blank.
Okay. Gosh, this is a lot of responsibility.
It's a lot of responsibility when $5,000 is at stake.
All
right, tell us how you fill in that blank. Lucky.
I'll say lucky number.
Lucky number. Marianne, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
Lucky day.
Lucky day. All right. They're both good answers. You're up to $600, and we'll tell you what's going to happen next right after we have this message for you. Robert Spencer will be back tomorrow to meet a new player, and we'll start a brand new game. And we hope you'll join us next time, too. Will you do that,
yes,
folks?
Well, are
you
yes,
coming
that's
apart?
Very kind of you. Thank you. This is Gene Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are Miro electronic housewares, including the couple-minute percolator and the Miromatic Manhattan speed cooker, the modern way to prepare meals in minutes instead of hours. And Charm Goette, the completely portable gas grill that goes anywhere, instant flame without starter fluids or charcoal, Charm Goette products of Antioch, Illinois. And from the Chapstick people, Chapman's lotion, extra rich and non-greasy. With Chapman's lotion, your whole body can have soft, appealing, smoother-looking skin. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.